Thank you for joining me again on TMI Tuesday. And as we said, we're looking at the issues surrounding Nigeria being placed on the watch list by the United States. And we're actually having some guests in the studio, and I'll be starting right early with the North Republic of Nigeria and also constitutional lawyer. He served in the government of Adams. He served in the government of Adams, Comrade Adams Oshomole. And he is no one else but Adams Aliyu. Very, very good morning to you.
Good day, if you ask. Thank you, moderator. Merry Christmas.
And next to him, I have the General Overseer of Sword of Liberation Bible Church, Bishop Austin Igbasan. Thanks for coming, Bishop.
Thank you for having me. Good morning, viewers.
And next, I have a Public Affairs Analyst, Comrade Onomroba Salvation. Thanks for coming, Comrade.
Thank you. Complimentary.
All right, I'm expecting a Muslim cleric, Alhaji Alamin Alao, to discuss this with us as we progress on the show. But I choose to start with you, the legal practitioner, the constitutional lawyer. Let's get to see what this opinion of yours is all about in terms of the indictment of Nigeria by the U.S. government in tagging it as one of the countries that should be on the watch list over violations of religious freedom.
Well, when I read of this, that the USA has placed Nigeria on the world list over religious intolerance, I started to wonder, because that trespasses on the domain of international relations and diplomacy. There's a legal maxim: pars in parem, non habet imperium, meaning that a nation state cannot be subservient to another nation state. Pars in parem, non habet imperium. This is encapsulated in the United Nations chapter, Charter of 1945. And America was one of the pioneer signatories to the UN Charter that all nations are equal. After the Second World War. And pursuant to that, when Nigeria got independence in 1960, she quickly enrolled as a member of the United Nations, equality, sovereignty of nation states. And furthermore, the Vienna Convention on Diplomatic Relations, signed in Vienna, Austria, April 18, 1961, stressed the equality of member states. If so facto, U.S. has no local standing to declare itself the watchdog of the society, the policeman of the world, to have a list and blacklist Nigeria as a place of religious intolerance. We have a constitution.
Was Nigeria blacklisted? I don't get
no,
it.
No, okay, I mean, well, they placed Nigeria
on the watch list.
Watch list. The focus in binoculars on it. It is malafide.
But not yet a country of concern. But not yet a country of concern.
I know, but that is focus binoculars on Nigeria and trying to talk of intolerance is ultra vires, malafide, and in very bad faith. Because our constitution is supreme. It guarantees, if you look at chapter 4, that 13 freedoms there, version 38 specified freedom of worship. You can have any religion. We are a secular state. So to condemn which, the raison d'etre of the U.S. having a watch list placing Nigeria there is ultra vires, malafide, uncalled for. It is later on now, along the line, we shall look at the parameters what led it to do so.
Okay.
Because all countries are equal in the eyes of the United Nations and in the Vienna Convention.
Thank you. Boringly from what Adams Aliyu said, Nigeria is a sovereign state, and the U.S. government declaration through the statement credited to Michael Pompeo, the U.S. Secretary of State. Do you think this is an interference, being that Nigeria is a sovereign state? Bishop Austin.
Well, Nigeria is a sovereign state. I think in the subsequent government, when there are constitutional infractions, the same people in power today call for U.S. intervention. So nobody should talk about. We have had a situation that happened in Gambia. Our president was there to make sure the president of that place step aside. Is it that Gambia is an Abia state? is here Ebonyi State. That is not to say that whatever happened in a country has a spillover to other country. So that is why U.S. is a senior brother to Nigeria. We cannot equalize with U.S. Whatever the charter has said, in this country, when there are constitutional infractions, or in other place, I remember the time of Lore Gbagbo, the president of Nigeria was there to give his counsel. Is it because their country is part of Nigeria? No, because whatever happened in any country has a ripple effect. If Nigeria become intolerant as religion is concerned, and that's a crisis, America is going, people are going to be coming to America, they will not have power to say they should go back. People will seek asylum. So they shouldn't watch and open their eyes and allow Nigeria to crash down before they will start talking. So to me, America has intervened in issues that concern Nigeria, not because during the election of 2015, the ambassador of Nigeria was going from state to state, as if he's an electoral officer. In 2014, the man was going from state to state, from Ekiti to each state. Is it because Nigeria is part of America? No, but because they knew that anything that happened with with what has been declared, that will be the end of 2015 election. They knew that whatever happened to Nigeria, we have an effect. So we must not close our eyes. There are things that are morality, there are things that are law. So to me, if for America to come out and start talking, Americans are not just flippant talkers. They talk on research. They will not just come and make a statement or incite Nigerians. Come an African country like us who can just come up and just make a statement. So America, to me, are people that verify whatever they say. Let us look at Nigeria in 2015. They said Nigeria is going to go on flame. If former President Jonathan at that time has not used his own morality to go out to make a call, pull a call through to his opponent and fellow contender and said, I congratulate you. What the Americans said then, will it not have happened in Nigeria? Don't we see the atmosphere that it was somebody decided to follow the road of morality? And that was what eased the tension, and Nigeria and the tension. People will have lost their life, lost property. So what we are talking about, America talking, I don't see it as an infraction, because this is not the first time America will talk about what is happening in Nigeria or give a caution, even to their citizens. When they see that anything is volatile in any state in Nigeria, they quickly tell their citizens not to go to that place. That is not that they are controlling or they have not contravened the law. I felt that as a senior brother to Nigeria, that they see something going wrong, they have the power to say, we put you on so-so list. Because of what we have seen, okay. I decided on my own, this is my opinion, that America will not wake up and just start putting Nigeria on the list without a thorough search, a thorough research, and they have been able to itemize something.
Okay, let's look at the thorough research and let's see Nigeria as it is, a geopolitical entity, and the constitution of the country respects the religion of every one man, and it doesn't discriminate. Looking at the constitutional provision in this direction, will it be right on the indictment by the U.S. on Nigeria?
Well, if you look at the happenings, I really want to say that the way I feel what America brought, what they are saying, is like when you have your family, neighbors, they can speak when they see something going wrong. It's now for us to look inward. Are there facts? What they have said now, if we look at the happenings of Nigeria, are there facts to this? Look at the happenings. For example, they are talking of religious freedom. We have an issue of Nigeria is divided into two major religions. There are other religions, but there is a Christian and there are the Muslims. You know, almost 50% the north and the south. So you look at the way the nation is going. With recent happenings and looking at what America is saying, that is a place where there's no religious freedom, they are watching us. Are there facts? Now let's look at the happenings. For example, Nigeria is a nationwide. Presently now, the leaders of the three arm of government in Nigeria are from a particular religion. The leader of the executive, the leader of the senate, the leader of the judiciary. They are all the leader of the institution, the leader of they are all from one religion.
Is there a violation? Is it a violation?
It's not a violation.
Or as a matter of occurrence in governance?
Now, I'm going somewhere. Nigeria is a nation whereby recently I read in the papers, he has not come out to discredit that claim that the leader of the judiciary system, there was a conference of judges. He came out to say that the constitution needs to be amended to add more Sharia content. Now, you are asking if it is okay. I'm trying to tell you certain happenings that we should look at. I believe there are things that will be happening in a nation. Then you question yourself, if America is coming out with such a conclusion, what did they see? How can the head of the judiciary of a nation come out to say the constitution should be amended in favor of a particular religion? When you are in leadership and a nation like Nigeria that is evenly divided, we are careful with statements. These are statements. We have an issue of Elia Shaibu there, a girl who we have a government who fought to release girls who were kidnapped by Boko Haram for years. Over 2 years after then, this girl is still in captivity because she belongs to a religion.
Is that your perspective?
That's what the Boko Haram said. They said they will not release her because she did not convert. That's what they said. So the only reason why that girl has not been released 2 years after others were released is because she belongs to a religion. And right now, the government that fought for the release of over 200 have not been fighting for the release of one. So I am giving you certain happenings that have been going on in the nation. When things like this happen, when we citizens say it, they term it as hate speech. So probably when outsiders say it, they will listen. So because some of us, we don't talk again because we don't want to be termed hate speech. So let America do the hate speech.
On today's daily, even the military did say that they are looking out, searching for Leah Sharibu. And so which means the federal government is not committed to this.
2 years after the 200 persons were released, they are still looking for. What my question I've always asked, why was the negotiation accepted that Leah Shaibu will not be free on the basis of her religion? If okay. She and her mate were kidnapped at the same time. So I'm just trying to tell you the happenings. For example, we have a nation where a woman who is a preacher was preaching somewhere about a year ago, and she was killed. Who has been prosecuted for that? She was killed. So they are happening. So that's why I want us to go back to the fact. Let's forget what they said. Let's look at, let's come home. Are they correct? Are these things really happening? Are people suffering in Nigeria because of their religion? Because when you say religion, freedom, what it means is that I am suffering for something because I belong to a particular religion. So is America right? I think that's what we should be looking at.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. And I'm telling you, let's look at this critically, the aspect of Leah Sharibu's release that is the really on the front burner that we are not able to really get really in reality. Do you see the government of the day treating this with kid gloves?
Well, warfare. I'm not a combatant soldier. Neither did I train in militarism. Warfare has its own tactics. We don't expect the soldiers fighting in Sahibu Forest, Sambisa Forest, to disclose their modus operandi. I am guided by the Constitution as a constitutional lawyer. Chapter 4, Section 38, specifying freedom of worship. And for the avoidance of doubts and ease of reference, I will quote, every person shall be entitled to freedom of thoughts, conscience, religion, including freedom to change his religion or belief, and freedom either alone or in community with others, and in public or private, to manifest and propagate the religion's belief in teaching, practice, and observance, unquote.
Mm.
The isolated case of Shaibu is condemnable. When there's warfare, there could be victims, circumstantial byproduct of a non-malus situation. He tried to cite that the executives of a legislative judiciary are all of the same faith. Nobody held election. Nobody planned it to be so. In the preceding era, Jonathan is a Christian. So are many others. So The Constitution guarantees freedom of worship. The idea of saying that they want to Islamize the whole country is unfounded. There is no way, nowhere, this is not Saudi Arabia, where Islam is the official religion of the state. I know that once upon a time, in the 80s, a certain head of state went to OIC, Organization of Islamic Conference, and enrolled Nigeria as a member. But it ended there. Right now, on Fridays, the Muslims go to their mosque. Sundays, Christians go to church. A time will never come in Nigeria where you and I will be forced to go to mosque if we are not Muslims, where Muslims will be carried and put and be imprisoned for not going to church. It's a secular state. It's enshrined in the Constitution. And the Constitution is the ground norm. Any other thing that is not in tandem with it is to that extent null and void. We should not be extremists. We allow freedom of worship in this country. America itself, that has become the monitor of the whole world, America itself was a British colony. It got independence on July 4, 1776. It fought a civil war. It led to the Boston Massacre of 1770. It led to the Boston Tea Party in 1773 in the state of Massachusetts. They got their independence almost 100 years before. So are other countries. So it is aggrandizement, ostentatious advertisement for it to be the monitor, assume the role of the prefect of the whole world. Before the Soviet Union collapsed in 1992, as a Sovietologist, I was editor in the Daily Times and the Punch, I attended the Great October Socialist Revolution, November 7 every year for about 17 years. The Soviet Union challenged America face to face, one on one. Yuri Gagarin went to space, the man. Valentina Tereshkova went to space. And they were able to put up an instant block as a check and balance. So the idea that America is omnipotent, omniscient, and it is the police of the whole world, should be discountenanced. They are a party to the Vienna Convention, signed by all countries, over 180 countries, since 1961. They are a party to the UN Charter. They were the first to sign in 1945. Nigeria signed in 1960.
Okay.
So nobody should think that he's omniscient and is the policeman of the whole world. We are an independent sovereign state. Pass in parallel, non-habit in peril.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Adams Aliyu. Well, as the topic on Nigeria being placed on the watch list by the United States, and we'll be extending the frontiers of this discussion after this break. Stay tuned.
TMI, every opinion counts.
Thank you for joining me still on TMI Tuesday. While we had a break, we were opportunity to enjoy the presence of a legal practitioner, a Muslim cleric, Alhaji Al-Amin Alao. Thanks for coming.
Thank you very much.
All right. Well, before I come to you, Al-Amin Alao, let's get your viewpoint, Bishop Austin Igbasan, over the statement credited to the Minister of Culture and Information, Lai Mohammed, that this issue of United States being inducted in Nigeria was that United States fell on the antics of some few Nigerians who are not patriotic, and maybe who lost out in the previous election to tag Nigeria a bad name. What do you make of that?
I don't agree to that because Americans are not babies. And beyond Americans, we are here, like Barrister Adams was saying. I want to say that in this same government, in the first term of our president, he has hosted the OIC three times. When you said the matter was laid to rest after, before he come on board, he has hosted OIC three times. Before this government come in place, we in Nigeria, we live together as Muslim and Christian. When the Christian is celebrating, the Muslim join us to celebrate. When the Muslim is celebrating, all of us celebrate together. But after 2015 election, by the calculation of how the election went, we were able to know that this election go in two directions, the South against the North, the Christian against the Muslim. And what was said then was that there is need for reconciliation. And the reconciliation can only come from the father of the house. So what we are saying that beyond what America has said, what is happening around us, it's like somebody said, you dey curse. Somebody say you too dey curse. And the person said, who say I dey curse? Make Ogun killer, Shango killer, make a moto jammer. If the person that say you are cursing, if we didn't hear the other one, what you are saying now, is it not curse? What you are saying that this person that said it should die, this one should happen. So what I'm saying is that the happiness, if you say Americans are liars and they don't have power to prognose over the affairs of Nigeria, what is happening around us that we can see? Let me give you an example. When this government came on board, a clause was put into that issue that involved religious leader, that everybody should go on retirement. If not for the outcry that people cry, leaders of churches would have been sent to go and sit down at home. Why? And this was targeted against the voice of those leaders that are speaking concerning the ills of the society. If not, and eventually the government suspended it, it was not taken off. That clause was added in October 2015. It was not part of what was there with the previous government. So what we are saying around us, my brother cited the issue of Leah. If the Nigerian army can bring out some numbers of persons, and only one person was abandoned in the course of religion. I also tell you today, security architecture of Nigeria, check it from 1960 to date. There have never been a time that everybody that had the security organ of Nigeria come from one religion, and it is only two persons that you can point to today. I give you an example of Ambassador Oke. Ambassador Oke was eased out of the power. Another person from another religion was brought on board. The IG today, the CG of custom, the DG of SSS, even the one of Matthew Useyefa, that when the president was not around, the vice president who was acting decided to say the invasion of the National Assembly is not the best. Let the man be eased out. Let the most senior person. And within 1 month plus that Matthew Useyefa was there, we knew what happened. But eventually, Matthew Useyefa was left, was sacked, and somebody that had gone on retirement was brought back. How do you explain that one to an Ijaw man? Now, I also say, look at the way the Chief Justice of Nigeria was eased out since 1987. We had it last in the days of Justice Ayo Erekefe. That was when Satan I ever had a Chief Justice of Nigeria. We knew what happened before CJN was confirmed. He had to be confirmed by a vice president who was acting president then. All of us are shouting. Because okay. What I'm saying is that somebody say you dey curse. You say, who say I dey curse? Make Ogun killer. Make Sango killer. If we not hear that curse, where you dey do before? This one, where you dey do na prayer? So all of us are believing together. We, both Muslim and Christian, we stay in the same house. We live together. But we must see leadership, though it is not in the constitution, that religion must be, but morality design it that we should balance ourselves by our own religion. We are governing ourselves. We look at what happened in Kaduna State. And El-Rufai did something and said, oh, nobody should preach, you collect license and all the rest. He went ahead knowing fully well that Kaduna is Kaduna North, Kaduna South, so that everybody will be balanced. At the end of the day, he picked a deputy governor. Today, Kaduna South people are sidelined. Okay, no, it is not about the people, it's about the leadership. We are ready to live together. We stay together with Muslims. We are not fighting ourselves.
Thank you. Thank you. Let's get a viewpoint of Alamin Alao, because a lot has been said here, and in terms of appointment being given under the present leadership of President Muhammadu Buhari, which seems, as they say, lopsided, and also the non-release of Leah Sharibu based on her Christian faith. All of this, does it not suggest that there are signs of violations against religious freedom?
Thank you very much. You see, I will start by quoting the verse of the Quran, the purpose of this program. And that verse is Quran chapter 3, verse 64 to 67. God is saying that all people of the scripture, referring to the Jews and the Christians, come to a common word that is common between us and you, that we worship none but God alone, and that we associate no partners with him, and that none of us will take others as lords besides Almighty God. Then, if they turn away, say, we bear witness that we are Muslims, that we submit.
That's a beautiful verse, a beautiful verse from the Quran. But in practice, it seems...
There's another verse I'm going to quote.
Okay.
Quran chapter 49, verse 13. God is talking, and I quote, O mankind, We have created you from a male and a female, and have made you nations and tribes, that you may know one another. Surely, the most honorable of you in the sight of God is he who is most righteous. Surely, God is honoring all of us.
Okay.
Now, these two verses are quoted. One has to do with avoiding religious coloration,
divisions.
The other one has to do with tribal discrimination and whatever. And that is the problem that the so-called leaders, quote unquote, of the world, used to divide and to segregate us. And unfortunately, we play along. We play along. We always like to point accusing figures to the other tribe, to the other religion.
So are you by this saying that the indictment is by trying to divide us?
The indictment is trying to divide. It's already dividing us. Though I came late, but from the little I've entered the studio, I even the question posed to me. It's already dividing us. If we are to start, the constitution of this panel cannot stand. Because I am the only Muslim here. The presenter is a Christian. the clergy is a lawyer, is a Christian. So if you must balance it, you start by inviting two Muslims and two Christian clerics. But we will not say no, because these are Nigerians. These are Christians. And God has said, see, let us go to a similar world, that we worship one God. That we are friends, we are families.
Yes.
We should learn to be tolerant. Religious tolerance should not be on the lips. It should be by practice. Why will a country, the so-called police of the world, that cannot police itself effectively, that a small boy will enter the classroom and kill his mates and kill the teachers? And nobody will call him a Christian terrorist. They will say, no, he's a terrorist. But if it happens, if the assailant is a Muslim, it's a Muslim terrorist. When do we start mentioning religion before mentioning the crime I've been committed? The press is also guilty of this, because they too participate in saying Muslim terrorist. But if a Christian commits a crime, nothing like Christian terrorist. As far as I'm concerned, what you do as a person, as an individual, is what I used to assess you.
Okay, but what's the way forward? Because
not the religion you proclaim.
Okay.
Because how many of us are Christians? How many of us are Muslims? We are deceiving ourselves. Christian means being Christ-like. Be like Christ. Can we be like Christ? Can we fast for 40 days and 40 nights consecutively? Christ did not get married. If we want to really be like Christ, then don't get married. We have some godfathers. We have those who are fathers who don't get married. You cannot be like Christ. Christ says that it was said, that shall not commit adultery. But I'm telling you now, any man that looks at a woman lustfully has committed adultery in his heart. Are we not looking at women lustfully? Are women not opening their breasts once and enjoying it? Can we be like Christ? Then let's come to Muslims. How many can be like Muhammad? Can we be like Muhammad? When our leaders are running for money here and there, they are in power and abusing power.
Okay, so witness, we all fall short.
You see, we all fall short. The governors, they are all Muslims and Christians, they are basing our... We are talking of religious jingoism here. Let us be one day be sincere. You guys should mind his business. Nigeria is a sovereign nation. And Nigeria has a constitution which is the ground norm, which is superior. At the time, the rumor was, by so years, Nigeria don't have been in existence, whether 2010 or so. What happened? The weapons being used by Boko Haram and all the terrorists all over the universe, was it manufactured in Nigeria? Is it not the same these foreign powers that manufacture them and then look for a way to sell them? If they do not divide you, how will you buy the weapons to kill yourselves? They need to divide you so that you need to buy their arms. Yes. They make their money from that. And then we still go about shouting, Muslim, this one is from north, this one is from south. That is why I started to put those two verses of the Quran, and they are also present in the Bible.
Yeah.
Talking of submitting to the will of God, to preach and practice. Matthew 7:21, Jesus said to me, Lord, we enter the kingdom of God, but he that does the will of my Father who is in heaven. And doing the will of God today is what is called Islam. So if you say I'm not a Muslim, you are saying you are not doing the will of God. Islam and Muslim Arabic language. The English meaning is the person that does the will of God.
Okay, now let's look at the way forward. Let's look at the issues that seem to indict us, like the aspect of appointments, you know, and also the aspect of the Boko Haram, the insurgency fight, the farmers and herdsmen clashes. Yes. Don't you think the leadership should set things straight in a better way?
Boko Haram has been in existence right from the time of Jonathan, even before then. At the time when Jonathan was in power, because a Christian leader is ruling, that is why Boko Haram said we must take over Nigeria. But fortunately or unfortunately, Boko Haram continued while Buhari is there as the leader. When Boko Haram started, they were destroying churches and mosques. The Muslim partiality is even greater than the Christian partiality because it's taking part in the north, which is dominated by Muslims. We should not allow foreign aliens. I use the two. They are foreign, they are aliens.
For emphasis.
Yes. To come and further divide us. We were lucky that after the Nigerian Civil War, we are trying to find our balance. We should not allow another civil war where U.S. will be able to send its ammunition, will be selling to you in the north, I'll be selling to you in the south. I'll be selling to you the Muslims, I'll be selling to you the Christians.
Okay, but the book lies in the leadership to be a prototype.
Now,
so what's your advice to
calling,
the leadership?
I'm coming on an appointment. By the time you are calling that so-so person should be appointed based on sex or tribe or religion, then you are invited to mediocrity. Appointment should be based on qualification. Appointment should be based on qualification, not where you come from, not where you profess. If you are saying northerner, southerner, then we should not believe in Christ and Muhammad because they are foreigners. They are not even Nigerians.
Okay, but are you saying that we can't get such qualifications or requirements as it pertains to qualification in other religions?
By the time a Christian is appointed to office, and I, a Muslim, I stand up to say, why do you put the Christian there? Then, of course, I'm not tolerant. Because I should not be bothered with the religion he professes. Is he going there to work, to serve, or is he going to eat money? If you're actually going there to serve, in fact, you want other adherents of other religion to occupy all the seats to serve you. But because we know that they did not go there to serve, they go there to enrich themselves. That is why you want adherents of the religion to fill the offices. To enrich themselves. If it's service, you say, no, let them do the work. Let them work for us. That's my ass boy. That's my ass F. You see Dan Ladi, you see Umar. He's a gate man to Emmanuel. Emmanuel is a Christian. His gate man staying outside is a Malam so person. He's protecting him. That's what he's doing. If you go there in Nigeria to serve, nobody will say, oh, this person does not belong to my religion. Because you know he's there to serve and to work. And there's money to gain. But because we know that in Nigeria, you are going there to eat and to embezzle. That is why you want your church member or your mosque member to be there. So that I can pass the largesse to you. And that is why we are failing this country.
Okay, thank you.
We are not being realistic.
I think from all you just said, yes, and the time allotted you shows that there's no discrimination here. Even though we have more Christians here and you alone are Muslim, but you've taken much time. Yeah, I think you are okay with that.
I'm not okay with that.
You have to take
okay, now let's get your viewpoint in this, the way forward.
Yes, I first want to say this. Nigeria, we have a way of selecting the constitution. I've noticed that whenever the outsiders foreign, when they praise our government, we listen. If America had said something very nice about the Buhari administration, we would have never come out to say we are a sovereign nation. When we are sick and want to travel out and go have hospitals to treat us here, we don't remember that we are a sovereign nation. When we can't depend on ourselves, we don't remember that we are a sovereign nation. It is only when it's against our opinion that we remember that we are a sovereign nation. For example, we are talking about constitution. If we really obey the constitution of this country, will El Zakazi still be in detention till now?
Okay, so what?
Is there not a court order that said this man should be released?
Okay, what's your prayer? What's your prayer for the current leadership in discussing this with the United States? Do you think it's necessary?
I don't think discussion with the United States is necessary. I feel like my imam here said something that they are trying to divide us. Are we already divided? Is it what they are saying now that is bringing the division, or it's already here? We are not one. That's the reality. The truth is that what we need to do now is leadership has to take steps to show to everybody
Muslim and Christian start, we are together. The truth is this, let's be real. Our leadership have not been very sensitive to the religious divide of the nation. By the time a nation is evenly divided between two religions like this, Christian and Muslims, even though you see 10 competent Muslims to occupy a position, but you are sensitive to the character of the nation, it makes you to look for a competent person from another because you understand the people. Okay. So by the time you fill everyone with a particular religion, with the claiming that they are the ones that are competent, it means you are not sensitive to the environment.
So the narrative should change in that direction. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I take that as a submission. Now, Adams Aliyu, the way forward for the leadership.
The way forward is that Nigerians should realize, instead of being sentimental, there is a difference between elected office and appointable office. The Chief Justice of Nigeria, once upon a time, was relieved of his position. He was appointed to that office. He didn't win election to be there. When he was appointed, heaven did not fall. It is when he is removed now and his next in command is sworn in, heaven wants to fall. He was not, he didn't win election to go there. Look at the position of Inspector General of Police. When Solomon Alase left, it was the 18th person to him, number 18, that took over. The present IG was not the next to the last IG. There is a difference between appointable positions and elected positions. Mm. Section 305 gives the president the power to do many things. The president can even declare a state of emergency. If, as it was done in Ekiti, done in John, by Obasanjo at the time. So instead of us to be sentimental, I start to lubricate and galvanize what Lelen Muslim lawyer said.
As a Christian, in this case.
Not be sentimental.
Yes.
The difference between appointable position, the president can appoint anybody, and elected position. And not only that, Christians have ruled this country. Obasanjo is a Christian. Jonathan is a Christian. Heaven did not fall, nobody made you cry. If a Muslim is ruling town, they say he wants to Islamize the country. It is bullshit and unpracticable to think that next Friday, every Nigerian will be carried to mosque to go and worship.
Yes, but again, we must be careful with the words we say. Yes, I think we should be careful with the words we say, if I heard you correctly.
Yes, it's not possible. Everybody must be dragged to a mosque to become Muslim on Friday, and everybody dragged to church on Sunday. No. Freedom of worship, Section 38, allows freedom of worship. And if Nigeria is a secular state, we are not in Saudi Arabia. It is not compulsory. Let us be upright. It is hard to have a utopia, a perfect country where everything is perfect. So we should not be sentimentally flabby.
Thank you. Thank you. It's expected that we are civil in our presentation, and opinions expressed by the makers are that of the makers and not that of independent television. Back to you, Bishop Austin Basan, as we round off. What do you see as the way forward for Nigeria in spite of this religious intolerance, seemingly?
I bring a parable. In my place, they said, you are begging a native doctor to make medicine for a madman. You didn't beg the madman to accept to drink it. Because even if you gather the whole of ring road to hold the madman, you cannot help the madman to sip in that concussion. It takes the discretion of that man to sip it in. So you don't need an outsider to tell you that your house is leaking. Because number one, the outsider is not staying in your house. But like I said, even the corrupt, the prosecution, so to say, of those who have been sent to jail, and they are all Christian. And I give you an example of Mrs. Oyo Ita. Oyo Ita came on board when the issue of minor. My learned brother here, and senior brother, who said when the Chief Justice was appointed, heaven did not fall. Heaven fell. Heaven fell before it was confirmed. He was not confirmed. We have to draw heaven in this same station.
When you heaven, say heaven fell.
Yeah, what I mean by...
I mean, you don't mean literally, because if it fell, we won't be here.
No, what I mean is that the heaven that my brother talked about... When he was appointed.
This is when he was removed now.
No, when he was appointed, I was in the same station here with Sonny Duke to say, in 48 hours, if our VP as an acting president and a lawyer did not confirm that man, and he did extension, then we know that he has disappointed his alma mater. So, heaven fell before the man was confirmed.
And it has to be confirmed when the president was not on seat that he was acting president. So I want to correct what you said, that heaven did not fall when he was appointed, when he was being eased out. It was the antecedent of how he was appointed, the malicious way he was put on acting. You are a lawyer. You know that in this country, there is nothing like acting chief judge. There is no acting chief judge since this country has started. It is against the law that somebody is acting. You are a lawyer, not a lawyer. What I'm saying is that you know that there is no acting. Is it acting in our constitution that a chief judge should be in acting capacity? Has it been done? It has not been done. So you have less than a with what I've said. What I said is that Maina came to this country and some people promoted him twice because of his religion. We cried out here. The woman stood her ground and said, I want Mr. President. What happened to that woman at the end of the day? The woman was eased out of power. So we are not fools. Exactly. What I'm saying is that almost all the people sent to jail today, check your record, you're a lawyer. There is no Muslim among them. I'm not championing that a Christian should be looting, but I say that there are cases that involve other religion, and the government of the day turn their eye elsewhere. No, what I'm saying is that if you are sending your child to go and buy cigarette for you, you are planning that child to go and start smoking their hemp or when he grow up, because we are all seeing this. We don't need Americans to tell us what is happening in our house. We are the one talking now. But because our voices are not heard, that is why the senior brother have to talk. Not that America is sinless or they are saint. They are not saint. But this is what is happening to us.
They have their own problem.
You can't say we don't have DJ, we don't have SSS who are Satana. Why do they bring somebody for retirement? Because most 7 persons in SSS are all Satana.
Thank you.
So what we are saying is that we should look at what the government of the day must look at it and say, we are Christian and Muslim, and Christian have competent people, Muslim have competent people. We should make sure we spread it across. It should start by example, not we that are here. We will only cast our vote. We will not choose. After God of heaven, the president of Nigeria is the most powerful person on earth, apart from witches and wizards. So the president can do anything. The president
can Bishop Austin Mbasa, you've expressed your point well enough. And Bishop Austin Mbasa is the general overseer of Sword of Liberation Bible Church. Thanks for making our time to be here.
Thank you so much.
Christmas Eve. Well, tomorrow is Christmas.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So in 20 seconds, what do you have to say to the viewers?
I have to tell everybody, both Christian and Muslim, it is time to celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ. And it is a time to share. It's a time to show love. It's a time to forgive. It's a time not to keep malice with people. It's a time to help the less privileged. Because the three wise men came and they presented gifts. Let us make presentation of gift. People are suffering all around us. We should show kindness to them. Gospel is not only preaching. We must also act it by alleviating the pain of other people. No matter how you look at yourself, you are better than somebody. So because you are better than somebody, that old shoe, that old cloth, that old wristwatch, give it to somebody. Give rice to people. Give a file to people. Help some person. Put smile on their face.
Thank you. This
is not the time to break bottle. It's not the time to stay in club. It's not the time to use what Jesus come to eradicate to be celebrating. You can't change your girlfriend because of Christmas. Because that is Christmas. Christmas without Christ is Christmas.
Thank you. Thank you. You are a Muslim cleric, Alamin Alao, and we look at the celebration of Christmas tomorrow. Your Christian brothers and sisters.
He has to come and visit me.
As we look at the celebration,
I think religious tolerance should take place from this.
As we look at the celebration of Christmas, I think one of the ways we can look at it is to try to really emulate the life
of Christ.
And of course, emulating the life pattern of Christ requires us to be religiously tolerant.
I'm happy you recognize him as Christ.
As tolerant as the Muslims have been, and as the Muslims will continue to be.
Okay.
And anybody who is tolerant is categorized as a Muslim. You see, for example, now, if we are talking of religious sentiment, Muslims in this state who are not less than 40% of the population should be complaining that, why do we have Christian ticket? Why is the governor a Christian and the deputy is a Christian? Why are the commissioners Christians? That should not be the order of the day, please. We are one. We should not try to further divide this country.
Okay.
By the time you are talking about what happens at national level, about the state we are. Muslims have never carried placard. We have the crosses in our hospital signifying the crucifixion of Christ. We don't believe in that. We don't cry. We don't have Friday public holidays.
No, Moses, everybody is not falling. Moses were made to attack other missionary schools.
Thank you.
Colonial masters, everybody is not falling. So we should please be preaching religious tolerance to our followers. Love the Christians, love the Muslims, love the Hausa, love the Igbo, love the Yoruba, love the Edos. That should be the words coming out from the men of God, so that this world will be a peaceful place. By the time we are identifying problematic areas, we are not pointing out to the things that unite us. We are always bringing the things that divide us. Then there will be problems.
Okay, because thank you.
We are the ones that control our congregation. You go to your church and to your mosque, please be tolerant. We are not striving for this world. My kingdom is not of this world. Christ said, we are striving for the hereafter. And we're talking of eternal salvation and not material salvation.
Thank you, Alamin Alau. Well, let's take your expressions for Christmas in 10 seconds.
Christmas is all about love. Go ahead and show love to someone. Don't be bitter. And don't steal because of Christmas. You know, don't put your family under pressure because you must buy something. You have nobody to impress. Just show love, and that's it. Don't go beyond your spending. Don't drink and drive. Don't get drunk and get accident because you want to celebrate Christmas.
Thank you.
That's not Christmas. Celebrate.
That's something else. Thank you, Adam Zalu.
From my own side, they have said it all.
Yeah.
We should not try to acquire the whole world because it is Christmas. The Lord will say, "Vanitas vanitatum, omnia vanitas." Vanity upon vanity, they are all vanity. So Christmas will come and go and will remain. So we should make do with what we have.
Thank you.
There's no El Dorado anywhere.
Thank you. Adam Zaliu is a constitutional lawyer and notary public of Nigeria. So you always hear him zeroing everything he's saying on the law. Thank you very much for that. Thank you, guest gentlemen, for pulling out on the show. And big thanks for viewing this. Don't forget, it's this morning on ITV. Big thanks, Alamin Alau.
Thank you very much.
All right. So stay with me. Don't you go away. No.